Hello again, so happy you could join me on this beautiful day. I hope it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. I'd like to start off by thanking all my viewers and subscribers. I do appreciate all the comments you've made. I always try to get back with you as soon as I possibly can. Today, I thought we'd do maybe an oval scene. It's a pre-stretched canvas, 16 by 20. What I did was I put contact paper over it, made an oval, cut it out, pasted that on there, and then spray painted. You can spray paint it in any color you want. Use your local hardware spray paint, but make sure you're in a well-ventilated area and have a mask on. Then after I did that, I peeled this away and I spray painted the line. I put the contact paper back on and I spray painted it with the other colors that you get from the hardware. Get the different shades and everything. That's a lot easier to do than trying to mix it with oils. And then what I did was I covered this part with a thin coat of liquid clear, and that's going to help the oils go on a lot smoother. And any information and all the colors you'll need to paint along with me will come across the screen right about here. Well, like I said, maybe we'll do a lighthouse, and maybe we'll do three-dimensional. Maybe the lighthouse is coming out of the oval. Maybe you have a palm tree over here, a little bit of a beach. Have the ocean out there, some palm trees. So that's where we're at. So I always like starting out with this fan brush, a little fan brush, real fine. To start out, maybe in the sky, we'll start out with some white. Kind of load it up on both sides, just like that. And we'll come in, maybe we'll put some light source right in here. Just going across, tapping all the way down. Get the idea. Something popping in there. Since we got some blue going on, a little bit of purple over there, we'll grab a little bit of purple on the same brush, just like that, with the same colors. Just tapping it, gonna get some cloud effects going. I'm gonna wipe some of that off. It's a little bit too bright. So you wipe it off and you come back in. And you can grab some of that white from the light. By doing that, it pulls from this color, this purple from over there. Here we'll just have the clouds go up, misty, kind of the way it looks in nature. When you look at the sun or the clouds, or once you start painting, you'll look at things, nature, in a different light. See all the reflections and all the shadows. Got that going on. I'm going to come across a little bit more, and we're going to come right across in front here. Maybe with partial clouds going over the front of it. Who knows, maybe it goes all the way back here. Goes all the way down. Wherever you think, you step back, you look at it. Now, I think we're going to mix some blue in with that same color, that pink. and get a purple. Just like the sky. Just like that. Just like in this corner here. Kind of blended it right in. Got all kinds of things happening off in the distance. Now I'm going to clean that fan brush off. I'm going to come back in and put some water lines in. Load up that brush again with some white for the reflection down in the water, and then we're just going to tap it, the edge of it. Right where you think the reflection might be. Loading up some more paint. All the way down. Come right down into the water. Right down to the beach. Going across. Sometimes it doesn't always come in perfect. Just tapping some waves, distant waves. Just using the corner of the brush. If you tap down harder, you'll see that gives you the illusion of white caps off in the distance. And that's all we're trying to do here, is create an illusion. Way into this. As far down as you want. As far down as you think you want your beach, where you want your beach to start. Come into some of the pinks, do the same thing on the other side. You want that reflection coming down in the water. Right along the side of it, all the way down. brighter, a little bit brighter pink, I think. All the way down. Just blending this in at the horizon, the pinks and the whites. So you got that illusion. All the way down.
Clean that brush off.
I use odorless paint thinner, it's always a good thing. Now I'm going to come into the palette knife. Going to get a little roll of paint. Come in and tap. Tap a water line up there, where it enhances it. You got that rough look. That's just what we're looking for. Now we'll come in to this brush here. Another little fan brush. Load up some whites. Liquid white. We'll make a water line where the beach would be. First line of water. Maybe it's crashing right in the front here. So it's going to be brighter. It goes just like that. Maybe we'll put one back here, behind it. Another one crashing in. The harder you push, automatically looks like white caps. Get that. Get that look. Going on. Take that same fan brush, wipe it off as much as you can. I'm going to pull back on this wave. You give that. Gives you that misty, like where you got some foam. Down some reflection here. little bit of a reflection. I'm going to take the blender brush here and go right across. Take a little bit more white in there. Above the wave, there's always more reflection, brighter. Because it's hitting right off of that top of that wave. Okay, we've got that happening. We'll come in and we'll put some seagulls in. Seagulls, you need a little bit of black for underneath the wings, maybe their beak or their bill, or you're using a Schliner brush. Some paint thinner, maybe some liquid clear. Load it right up. What we're going to do is come in and, oh, who knows? I'm going to put one right down here, right by the water. Tap it. And just make its wings. Grab some more. Maybe there's one up here. I always have them flying in at different angles. The way they might look. Oh, who knows? Maybe I'll put another one right up here. Like that, get some liquid clear, kind of thins it out. So when you go to tap it on this seagull, it comes in a lot better. Same brush, little tap. Black on the edges. Little black on the edges. There's your seagulls. I want to use that liquid clear because thin paint sticks to a thick paint every time. Okay, we got that going on. I kind of like that just like that. We'll come in and we'll, I think, put a lighthouse back in through here. And then maybe a beach with palm trees here. So, let's just come into this brush here. Because we got these purples and stuff going on. Maybe we'll make our lighthouse a purple hue. A purplish lighthouse. Float it up on a brush just like that. Okay, maybe our lighthouse is coming right out through here. You can have it come all the way down. Maybe have a beach. Maybe have a beach in here. Grab some more of that color. Liquid clear. Darker as it gets towards the bottom. Wider. Blend it all in. Blend it in.
Got that purpley look. Loading the brush up again. Making it wider, wider at the base.
Wider at the base. More purples. Blacks. Let me see.
I'm gonna get into the different brush. That's flatter, and that's got a flatter edge to it.
blend all that in. I'm going to shade that in now, come into some light colors. Just let it blend in with the color we got on there. Just went like that, load it up. Just have it highlighted. Kind of naturally. Brush over. Now we'll blend it in. We'll pull this way. Colors are more dominating. Semi-circle. windows. Just a little brush with some black. Maybe some white. Maybe we'll make it more gray since it's so dark there. Just loading it up with some black, purple, and liquid clear. Little brush. Now we'll come in and we'll figure out where we want our windows to be. One there. And one there looks good. Clean off that brush. And we'll come in to the brush we were using on the lighthouse. Clean it off. Because we want to come in to just some blue color. Some blue and some white. Yellows and some reds and burgundy. Get a darker color, I think. It's good. Load it right up on a little brush. And we'll come in that we used. Come in and bring it all together. Palette knife, come right in and scrape. Scrape up the antenna that's on the lighthouse. Just like that. Brush.
little fan brush, and we'll load it up with some black, liquid clear, grays and blues, and come in and do the railing. The railing for the lighthouse. Sticking the edge and tapping it. Now we'll come in. Just go straight down. Tell you what I'm going to do. Come into this brush here. Small little thin brush. Got some shadow underneath there. Okay. Got that going on. Maybe out here we can have a couple more birds. Couple more seagulls. Flying right by the lighthouse. But I'm gonna need gray color for that. Rare color. One there. Maybe one right here. Three-dimensional. Now we'll come in and start putting some sandy area in. Beachy color. Somebody needs some browns. I'm going to use, now that I look at it, I'm going to use some purples for the shading. Since we
we got purples and blues in here. Just tapping this. I'm going to come in to the blender brush. Tap it in. Whites. I want it to be, I'll just call it white. Highlight it. Different areas where we think the sun might be popping it. Take the blender brush, try to wipe off all that excess we had on there, because all we want on there now is the white. Some highlighting. The blender brush again. Now we're going to put some bushes in. We're going to use this brush here, a 2-inch brush. I'm going to get some dark colors. Some browns and blacks. Pull it in one direction. Liquid clear. Helps to go on better. Pull it one direction. Get a rounded edge. I'm going to come in and tap this. Tap around them. Tap around the lighthouse. Something right down here. Beautiful. Just the way I like it. Now we can come in with this fan brush and highlight some areas in here. Where the light might be hitting. Doing is tapping this. You can kind of go up as high as you want. Whatever angles. Want to kind of get that in there with that light color. Really good at the pop there. Just like that. We'll come into the blender brush. We'll tap that at the bottom, just like that. Nothing more in there. I like that, just like that. Want to put a beach over here and a palm tree or not. It's like I don't have one of them. That edge off there. Well, I think I'm going to come in with the palm tree with some purples right here. Just tapping. Blender brush. Now I'll come into some whites. Brush. Try to get all that purple off there. Because all we want to do is tap this in. Looking good. Still gotta use more white though. More white. More white and more blending. Back and forth till you get that look. That look that tells you that you got it. Highlight some of this in here, kind of blend that in. More white, more white. Keep seeing more white. Keep seeing areas that I'm just not. Just not popping enough. Just not white enough. Back and forth. Just like that. Maybe we'll put some bushes in here now.